Okay, guys, today we're gonna go over the notes. And the notes is, okay, we're gonna go over 2.2, a day to solving multi-step equation note, okay? So you should have a copy with you in front of you. And the first step we're gonna do is solving equations with variables on both sides. One goal is to isolate. If you need a copy of the notes, let us know, we have more, okay? One goal is to isolate the variable, okay? Two rules, to get rid of something, use inverse operations. Anything we do not one side, we have to do it on the other side. The order in which you toggle,
just move it a little bit.
These problems is very important, okay? So steps, here are the steps. The steps are simplify each side of the equation. One, get rid of the parentheses, use distributive property. Number two is clean things up. Do not use inverse operations, combine like terms, CLT, combine like terms on each side of the equal sign separately. Three, isolate the variable, now use inverse operations. Three, get the variable terms to one side, okay? So we have to get all the variables to one side in order to start combining like terms. If you have variables on both sides, get rid of the one with the smaller coefficient. Four, get the number constant terms to the other side. If this is a constant on both sides, get rid of the one that is on the same side as the variable. Okay, number five, solve by getting rid of the coefficient, divide to get variable by itself, okay? So that those are the rules, the steps that we need to do in order to start solving equations with variables on both sides, okay? Questions, anyone so far? No? Yes? You need a copy of your paper for the notes?
Okay.
The one, yeah, no, it's a different one.
Okay.
Yeah, we have a different one for today.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to start working on the examples. Example number one, we have 3x plus 28 equals 24 minus x, okay? So we're going to start by adding 1x to both sides. We put a line in between the equal sign to divide both sides. So let's start with negative 1, positive 1x on both sides. So 3 plus 1 is 4x. Okay, we combine like terms. Plus 28, we move down the 28.
Huh?
El 1 is 1. When you have x by itself, means that you have a 1 in front of it. Okay, so that's the 1. So every time you guys see x by itself, technically, you have an invisible 1. Okay, so that's where I get the 1 from. Good question, though. Plus 28 equals 24. So now we go negative 28 on both sides. Negative 28. So 28, positive 28 and negative 28, we cancel them. We move down the 4x equals negative 4, and we get negative 4 because 28 minus 24 is negative 4. Now we have to divide 4 because we need to leave x by itself. So we cancel the 4s. We have x by itself, so x equals negative 1 because we're dividing it, okay? So if we divide 4 into negative 4, it's negative 1. So that's our final answer. Okay, so we have negative 4 and, sorry, negative 1 as the answer for number 1. Okay, and for number 2, I'm going to give you a few minutes to work on it. So, and I'll be working around to see if you have any questions or need any help. Let us know. Me and Milosano, we're going to be walking around. Raise your hands and go ahead and start working on number 2. Okay, I'll give you a few minutes. Shreya, are you doing okay? Questions? Okay, it seems like you guys are doing good. No questions so far. Are we ready to move on, guys? Yes? Okay, what is the first step that we're going to do on 2? I have you guys' names on here on my card, so I'm just going to pull out a name, and that person is going to answer me, okay?
I don't know the answer.
Okay. I'm going to close my eyes, Sam. Let's see. I'm not looking. This one. I have Hugo. Hugo, what is the first step that we're going to do, Hugo, on number 2? Hugo. We're trying to do number 2. And I got your name, okay? So that means that you're going to answer number 2. What is the first step that we're going to do on 2? Huh? Yeah, we have to do what? Subtract. Yes, negative 3x on both sides, right? So it's negative 3x. Yes, good job. Subtract. So we have 5 minus 3 is what? 5 minus 3?
2.
Very good. 2x. So we have 2x minus 8 equals, we cancel the 3s, so we get equals 12, okay? So now we have to add 8 into both sides, so we're going to go add 8 plus 8. So a positive 8 and negative 8 makes. I know I did. Okay. Negative 8 and positive 8. Yes, you cancel. So we move down the 2x and we end up having 2x over 2 equals 12 plus 8, 20. And the last step is to divide. Okay. So we cancel the 2. So we have x by itself. So x equals, we divide 10. Yes. Thank you. So the answer is x equals 10, okay? Any questions, anyone? I'll give you a few minutes to write it down.
So don't forget, you guys, always you have x, you have a value, okay? So x equals something. external set, which is last attribute defined. And yeah, you guys, the variable is equal to something.
Okay, do you guys need more time? One number two? Yes? No? Do you guys need more time to write it, Rosita? Are you doing okay? Number two? Okay, so let's move on to question number three, okay? So let's do number three. Actually, I'm going to do number three, and then I'll let you guys do number four. So number three, okay. So remember, we put a line in between the equal sign here. So we're going to start subtracting negative 7x. Here, so we put negative 7x, and then we do negative 7x on both sides, and we cancel the sevens. We cancel the sevens, so we have, okay, we have 12. Actually, we combine like terms, okay? We add the 9 and 3, so we get okay, never mind. We add, first we're going to add combined like terms on this step. We're going to add 9 plus 3 because they're on the same side. So if they are on the same side, we're going to add them first. Okay, so that will be easier for us to solve for x. So we're going to add 9x plus 3. We get, how much is 9 plus 3? 9 plus 3 is what? 12. 12x minus 27 equals 7x plus 43. Okay? So now we can subtract the 7. We're going to move 7x. 7x. And we cancel the 7s. So now we have 12 minus 7. How much is 12 minus 7? Okay, I'm going to start getting a name, and I'm not going to look. Mac. Okay, Mac. How much is 12 minus 7? 12 minus 7. Thank you. Okay. So we have 5. We have 5x. Minus 27 equals 43. Okay, so now we're going to add 27 on both sides. Cancel the 27s. And we get 5x here equals 70. We're going to add 43 and 27. Can someone tell me? Let's see, I'm going to get another name. Israel, how much is 43 and 27? Can you help me? Can you add them in the calculator? Can someone help him, please? 43 plus 27. 70. Thank you. Thanks for helping him. Okay, so we have 70, and then we divide it by 5. Thank you. So we divide by 5, so the answer is 14. Thank you. Yes. Okay. So after dividing, we get 14. Okay. Any questions, anyone?
No.
Okay. So right now I'm going to give you a few minutes to work on number four. Okay. Number four, we have 5x minus x plus 18 equals negative 2x and negative 24. And remember, when we have an x by itself, we have an invisible one in front of it. Technically, it's 1x. Okay? So on that one, pretty much, we are going to combine 5x and 1x. Okay? So I'll give you a few minutes to work on that one. Any questions, anyone? Hugo, are you doing okay? Mac? Are we doing okay? Vanessa, questions? Hey, Edie, how are you doing? Okay, raise your hand if you have any questions. Rosita, can you go to the okay, so let's go back and let's go ahead and start working on four, guys. Okay, number four. We're going to put a line on here. Okay, so we have 5x and negative x. And remember I told you when x is by itself, we technically have a 1 in front of it. Okay, right here. It's an invisible 1. So we can put it if you want to. Okay, so we have 5x and 1x. We subtract because we have different signs. So we get 4x. So the answer is 4x plus 18 equals negative 2x minus 24. Okay? Now we're going to add plus 2x, okay, on both sides. We're going to cancel the 2s. So we have 2, 4 plus 2. Can someone tell me what's 4 plus 2? Okay. 4 plus 2? 6. Thank you. Okay, so we have 6x in here. So we have 6x plus 18 equals negative 24. Okay. After this step right here, we need to subtract 18 on both sides. We cancel the 18s, and we end up getting 6x equals negative what? Can someone tell me 24 plus 18? How much is 24 plus 18? Okay. This one. Okay, who said it? Huh? Jose? Okay, 42. So we have negative 42 and we divide it by 6. Okay, can someone divide 42 by 6? Thank you. Yes, 7. But it's only 7 or is it negative 7? Thank you. It's negative 7 because when we divide different signs, it's always negative, okay? When we multiply or divide different signs, it's always a negative. So, yes, it's negative 7. Thank you. Okay? Okay, so I'll give you a few more minutes to finish your notes. And we're going to go ahead and do 5, and you guys are doing 6. Okay, we're almost done. Anyone has a question? Needs more time? Raise your hand. You doing okay, Hugo? Vanessa, are you doing okay? Okay. And you guys are doing number six by yourself, okay? So, number five. The first step, we have to distribute the negative 3 multiplied times 6x and then times negative 3. So, we move the 3x down, okay? And then 3 times 6 is what? Negative 18x. 3 times negative 3 is what? Plus 9 equals negative 10x plus minus 20 minus 6. Okay? So we subtract negative 15x plus 9 equals negative 10x minus 26. We add, when we have same signs, we add and keep the same sign. So we add plus 15x plus 15x on both sides. We cancel the 15s, so we have 10 minus 15 is 5, so 9 equals 5x minus 26. We're going to add 26 to both sides, okay? We cancel the 26, so 26 plus 9 is 35, so we have 35 over 5, okay? We divide by 5, we want to leave x by itself. So the answer is 7 equals x, or x equals 7. It's the same thing. Okay, on this one, guys, make sure you distribute this number and multiply it to whatever is inside the parentheses. That will be the first step. Once you guys do that, combine like terms, okay? So that will be the first step. Multiply the negative 3 times 6. We get negative 18. Multiply negative 3 times negative 3. We multiply same signs. It's always positive, okay? So it's positive 9. I'll give you a few more minutes to finish that one. And then you guys are working by yourselves on number 6. And then, of course, if you need me, you have questions, I'll be walking around here to help you. Okay, or raise your hand. Give you a few more minutes so you guys can finish writing this one. And remember, guys, you can always use your notes for the assessment, okay? Probably the assessment is going to be either Tuesday or Wednesday for next week, so you are able to use all these notes, okay? So it's very important right now that you're taking notes to take, put them like this all correctly so you will be able to use them during your test, okay? Number 6. Is there anyone done with number 6? Or have you started 6 already? No? Questions on number 6 before you start? Okay, number 6. Okay, just to remind you, for number 6, what will be the first step that we're going to do? Okay? We are going to... multiply 8 times 2, okay? So multiply 8 times 2x and then multiply 8 times negative 1. After you do that, you are going to combine like terms, okay? So let's do that first. Hugo, do you need any help? Questions? Okay, so questions, Nathan? Okay, so let's work on number 6. So we are going to multiply 8 times 2x. We get 10x, and then we are going to multiply 8 times negative 1. It's negative 8 equals 4x equals minus 116, okay? We're going to subtract negative 4x. Then we get 12x minus 8 equals negative 116. We're going to add plus 8 on both sides. Cancel the 8s, move down the 12x, divided by 12 equals negative 108. Because 116 plus 8 is 108, we divide it by 12. So x equals negative 9 for number 6. Okay. Did anyone got the right answer for 6? Almost. Who got the right answer for number 6? Yes? No? Vanessa? Did you get the right answer for 6? Okay. Okay, I'm going to leave you a few more minutes so you guys can finish it and copy it. Okay, make sure you finish it all. And questions, anyone? Nathan, questions? Pretty much the last part of the worksheet is extra practice for you guys, okay? We want to make sure that you guys get a good score on your assessment, okay? Remember that your assessments count 100% of your grade this year, so it's very important that you pass your assessments with a good grade, a good score. So that's why we're giving you extra practice, okay? So we want to make sure you complete 7, 8, 9, and 10, right? There's 4 questions. So make sure you complete them all, and we'll be walking around, me and Ms. Lozano, to see if you need any help. You have questions, let us know. And very important, use your notes, okay? You have your notes with you, use them all the time. Are you doing okay, Israel? Yes? Did you finish your writing number? What is it? Did you finish writing number 6? No? Yes? Did you hear on this one? I think that's one important is that you guys are creating the questions, right? Guys, don't forget, every time we do a lesson and the assignment, we need to create 3 questions and a summary on the bottom of your assignment, okay? This is for us to understand if you guys are understanding, how much help do you guys need, okay? So make sure you guys complete the summary on the bottom and your 3 questions, okay? Your summary goes right here. At least we need a question from you for your summary. A sentence, sorry, and 3 questions. Okay? If you need any help, please let us know. Can someone give me a question? And you can ask a question. And it has to be in regards to the assignment. Okay?
What's an example of press?
No, Okay, so I'll give you more time to write your summary and your questions. Okay, guys, so that's it. And questions, I'll be walking around, okay? Me and Milosano, like I said, will be helping you answering questions.